I've got to demo this mobile home out. It's an abandoned mobile home for an abandoned backhoe. Perfect little job to begin with. So there you can see it. Let's go inside and I'll show you the inside. Got some stuff here. Ow. Watch your head. Got a little, you know. Can you see that? It's got a little light coming out of it. Doll. Sucker's asleep. Let's see here. A couple board games. Y'all like Scrabble? So here is the job. The abandoned backhoe's first job is an abandoned mobile home. I can't make this stuff up. Let's look down here. It's windy today, guys. Old bathroom. So, yep, abandoned mobile home. Abandoned mobile home. Walk through, and this is my first job with the abandoned backhoe. Tearing this thing down. So, this whole property I'm cleaning up, so. All right, let's get started, viewers. But the first thing I want to do before anything else is smash the subscribe. What are you guys gonna do? got a chain there hooked up to my frame. See if we can pull this thing out. Now what do I do? I don't know what to do now, guys.
take you along to the dump, and then when we burn the wood, I'll take you along.
All right, let's take this to the dump. I got a load, probably one more load. Maybe not a huge load, but it's a load. I want to see how this dump deal is going to work. All right, let's go for a walk. I think that'll be it. I'll put some hay down, sprinkle some hay, maybe go over it a couple more times with the backhoe. It's still got some metal in there. I don't know if you can see. I gotta pull that metal out while I'm burning it. Here's the pile. Got some papers in there that scattered. But it's really a clean wood pile. I did a diligent job on it. So there's my wood pile I'm burning. I got a little extra scrap there. There's my trailer frame. Scrap, scrap, wood pile. 1.52 ton, can you guys see that? And 1.59 ton. So can you guys see that? So far two trips, I got a little more in there, but so far two trips to the dump.
Let's start this fire. Diesel. It's old, old diesel.
She's going now. The wind's blowing good too. I've got this open field I can fire watch. down before I can get in there to put those little fires out.
Funny, scary story. You know, it's a campfire chat. You know, you got to tell a scary, funny story. So, it's about the backhoe, since, you know, y'all know about the backhoe. So, whenever I bought the backhoe, I got it done. And as I had it done, you know, it doesn't have reverse or brakes or anything. I have to move it to the down by the road so a pickup person can pick it up, was my thinking. So this guy's driveway goes kind of downhill, and it's real close to his house that leads to the back where the backhoe was. Now, you know, started it up, drove it down this sketchy road, and the power steering was finicky to begin with. I had to do some work on it. But anyway, driving it down this road, well, it starts gaining speed because it's, you know, downhill. I'm thinking, man, this thing's going fast, and the, you know, steering is funny, and it doesn't have reverse, so I can't stop it that way. The loader bucket, if you push forward, it doesn't go down. You have to go to the right, kind of forward and to the right, diagonal, just because the way it is. I don't know if they're all like that, but so I'm used to them going forward to go down. So I'm, you know, I'm pushing down. I think, well, you know, how do I stop this thing? I push down on the control, it doesn't really do much. And then I push right, and finally goes down. Well, I'm gaining speed. It's not slowing down very much. So my quick thinking, maybe not so quick, I pull the fuel cut off, kills the engine. It comes to a stop, right? So I'm pretty proud that I didn't, you know, without any brakes, without, you know, didn't hurt anything. Kind of got it a little farther to the road than I wanted to, but I got out by the road. All right, I get down, you know, put the backhoe down. I walk around it a couple times looking for leaks. You know, the swing cylinders are leaking, so I'm having to, you know, see where all the leaks are. The swing cylinders were leaking bad. It just coming out pretty bad. So I walk around, you know, do an assessment. And as I'm walking back up the driveway, a flatbed, either like a crew cab Ford or Chevy pickup, I really can't remember, comes up the driveway. Well, you know, it's a later model pickup. It's not a new pickup. And I think there's three guys in the pickup. There's a driver, passenger, and then someone in the back.
So they come up and the driver says, hey, you know, what are you doing? I said, you know, I'm bringing the backhoe out there. He says, you know, what are you doing with my backhoe? He said, I said, a good one or something like that. I can't really remember what I said. And he says, does the owner know your, he says the name, but he says, does he know you're taking his backhoe? I said, yeah. He says, guys, this guy's stealing the backhoe. Yeah, right. I'm stealing a backhoe that I hadn't run it 10 years. Okay. So that's what I'm thinking. And then the, then he says, quick, get the gun or something like that. And then the driver or passengers, you know, opens the dash or the dashboard, the glove compartment, and acts like he's going to, you know, drops the pistol or whatever. And he's stomping around, you know, quick, get the gun. And, you know, the guy in the driver's seat is kind of perpetuating this. I'm going, man, I don't know what to think. So, you know, I look to my left. Do I run, you know? I really don't know what to think, you know? Am I scared? Do I, you know? So, this goes on for I don't know how long until he says, yeah, just joking. And that's the funny, scary story. I'd really, you know, I'm in a daze. My mind was in a daze past that. What happened? You know, am I scared? Am I, you know, laugh? I think I said, oh, yeah, good one. I think I said you almost got me, but I can't remember at that point. So that's the funny, scary story. I don't know. It's an odd thing. Odd thing for sure. Do you guys have any, you know, stories? That's my funny, scary fireside chat story of the, well, it was an abandoned backhoe. It's, you know, been put to use now. I don't know. Should I have been scared? You know, I don't know. It's an odd thing. Odd thing. You know, they were in cahoots, you know, the passenger and driver. They've obviously done that before, but funny. So now you know the story. I'm gonna be here for a long time.